Welcome again. Today we are looking at a lesson. We are deriving a lesson from Daniel's vision in Daniel chapter 8. And remember when I spoke to us last, I said that one of the characteristics or realities of the empires and the kingdoms that we are seeing in the book of Daniel is that they come and they go. You will realize that in chapter 8, now we are not even talking about the Babylonians. We are now starting to talk about, you know, the Medo-Persian. We are seeing two critical images in this vision. The first one is a ram, and the second one is a he-goat. And this he-goat is having, you know, some two horns, and there is this four horns that is coming, and there is this little horn. You know, so we are seeing two. There are two explanations to this. One, God may be showing us that, you know, these powerful empires and kingdoms will come and go, and so we don't have the Babylonian. But the other way we can think of it is that Daniel's and God's interest at this point is now to direct it to the Jews, so that they will be seeing the things or the kingdoms that are yet, you know, to lead them. Because, you know, the Babylonian kingdom is now passed, so they're looking at the future. And so that is a very interesting way to look at it. So we are looking at the Medo-Persian, who is being, you know, in the vision we are seeing him as a ram with two horns. One is a little bigger and the other one is smaller. Of course, the little bigger one is the Persian. And you know, it was more strong and powerful than the Median. And then we are looking at the Greek. We are seeing this swift he-goat. You know, I like the way Greek is being described in this vision, that, you know, it was swift to run, you know, looking at not only the Greek in general, but looking at Alexander. And then we are seeing the four horns that come from it. You know, when after Alexander the Great, we are seeing these generals who are coming in, you know, the generals who are leading the Syria, majorly known as the Sadducees, and then we are seeing the generals leading Egypt, the Ptolemy, and of course the Thrace, and also the Macedonian. So we are seeing all of them coming in very strong. There is a lot of war. War against the people of God, war against, you know, the sanctuary. But today I want us to pick a lesson. And my lesson will be actually from verse 14. It's a simple lesson. Let me read verse 14, and this is what the Bible says. He said to me, it will take 2,300 evenings and mornings. Then the sanctuary will be reconstructed. So we have seen the sanctuary being destroyed. We have seen the torture and, you know, a lot of bad things that are happening in the sanctuary. Sanctuary represents the presence of God. And when the question is asked by Daniel, until when will this happen? Then look at the answer. There is a limited time for this destruction. The Bible says it will only take 2,300 evenings and mornings. You know what that means is, if we are to look at the 24 hours for a day, is around maybe 1,500, you know, 1,550 days, or we are talking about 3.5 years. So there is a limited to all the terrible things that is going on in our lives. And then after that, there is a reconstruction of the presence of God. There is a reconstruction of the sanctuary. I want to pick a lesson here and say, friends, there may be terrible times, there may be hard times, but they are limited because their time will come to an end. You know, the Medo-Persian powerful kingdom will come to an end. You know, the Greek will come to an end. The generals of the Greek, of Alexander the Great, will come to an end. Their timing is limited. You know, the Israelites were being assured, you know, you were told 70 years. And now you only remain with 3.5 years. That should give you hope that very soon the things that you are going through will come to an end. And you see the glory reestablished once again in your life. So I want to declare that the glory of God will be reestablished in your life once again during this time and even beyond. Shalom.